On this video, I will give you a demo on how to use the Google Calendar for G Suite. We will talk about calendar interface sections, how to create an event, how to create a reminder, how to share a calendar, how to add a coworker's calendar, how to access the calendar settings, how to edit the calendar default event notifications. I have divided the Google Calendar web interface in the following sections: Google Bar, Actions, My and Other Calendars, Calendar. On this section you can find Google or company logo. Here is where you will see either the Google logo or your company logo if your administrator has set it up for you. Search box. You can search for the name of the event or someone that was invited to the event. Grid icon. On this button you will find shortcuts of other Google services like Mail, Sites, or Google+. Notifications. You can view notifications from a particular Google service like Gmail or Drive, even when you don't have it open. Account settings. This button will help you sign out of your account, switch accounts, or manage your account settings. For more information about the Google Bar, you can go to the Help Center article listed in the description. I call this section Actions because it allows you to perform different actions with your service. The Today button allows you to return to the current day when you don't have it visible anymore. The back and forward arrows allows you to access all dates or future dates. The View button allows you to have different views of your calendar: Day View, Week View, Month View, 4 Days View, or Agenda. The More button allows you to print the view you are in and to refresh it. And the Settings button where you can access the calendar settings. On this section you will find a mini calendar in a month view. All the calendars you have created and the calendars you have added from a coworker or other interesting calendars. This is your calendar. Here is where you will see your events and the events of other users that have shared their calendar with you. You can distinguish the calendar based on colors. You can hide or unhide a calendar by clicking on its color. To create a calendar event, you have two options. 1. Click on the Create button at the top left corner of the page and it will take you to this page. Or, on the calendar section, click on the date and time you want the event. If you need to add more details to the event, click on Edit Event and it will take you to this same page. Here you can name the event, set the dates and time that the event will take place. You can decide if the event will be an all-day event or if it will be a repeat event. Where is the place where the event or meeting will take place? You can make it a video call if you will use Hangouts for it. If you need that the guests have a document that they need to review prior or during the event, you can attach it here, and all the guests will get it along with the event invite. You can add guests by entering their email address on this section. You can add a color to the event and notifications, but keep in mind that these settings are only on a user basis. These settings will not be shared with the guests. When done, click on Save. To create a reminder, you just need to click on the date and time you want it, and then click on Reminder. Enter what you want to be reminded of and when, then click on Create. In order to share a calendar, first you need to look for the calendar you want to share and put the mouse pointer over it. Click on the down arrow and click on Share this calendar. You can make this calendar public by checking on this option or make it available for other users within your domain. The permissions that you will have access here will depend on what your administrator have given you access to. With these settings, you can allow other users to access your calendar by adding it under their other calendar section. If you need to share your calendar with someone specific, you can add the email address of that person on this section. I will add my info account here and select any of the following permissions. Make changes and manage sharing. The person will be able to create, edit, delete calendar events and share your calendar to any other users. Make changes to events. The person will be able to create, edit, and delete your calendar events. See all events details. The person will be able to view only the details of your events. See only free, busy, high details. The person will know if you will be free or busy at a specific time of the day. When completed, click on Save. If we move to the info calendar, we will find the sales calendar under My Calendars because it was shared directly to info. In order to add a coworker calendar into the calendar, go into the Other Calendar section and on this field enter the email address of your coworker and the calendar will be listed here. I will add the info account here. To access the calendar settings, you can click on the gear icon and then click on the settings. Or you can go to My Calendars, click on the down arrow, click on Settings, then click on General. Here you can set the country, time zone, date format, time format, etc. To check the settings of a specific calendar, click on Calendar and click on the calendar you want to view the settings. You will be able to rename it, add a description, get the code to embed the calendar in a website, etc. To edit the default events notifications of the calendar, you can follow these steps. Click on the down arrow of the calendar you want to edit and click on Edit Notifications. Here you can add a new notification by clicking on Add a New Notification. Select the type notification or email. If you select notification, it will pop up on your screen and if you select email, it will send you a message. You select the time before the event to get the notification or the email message. You can do this for regular events and all the events. When done, click on Save. I hope you like this video. If so, please like it and share it with your friends so more people can watch this video and learn about its content. And don't forget to subscribe. This is Mac and see you in my next video.